So welcome to your tutorial on how to calibrate TrolMaster sensors that comes with your FarmAnywhere container. So we have the 4-in-1 sensor here from TrolMaster. Ideally, you'd want to replace them at least once a year, since those are your primary way of monitoring the environment inside the farm. So that's quite important. So they're easy to replace, fortunately, and they're quite cost effective. So once you get the new one, or if you're replacing them, or if you are ready to start your farm, you're just going to plug it in like so. It's really just a plug and play system. And then you're going to want to wait a little bit for the sensor to read. And so we're only going to be calibrating today temperature, humidity, and CO2. And then once PPM is loaded, then we'll start the calibration. So we have this device here, an agrometer. So there's, you know, all kinds of different versions of these. This is like an Amazon version. That's not the cheapest, but it's also not the highest quality. There is some way higher quality ones at $2,000-$3,000 a piece. This is a decent one. We'll put the link in the description for you guys to look it up. So basically what we're gonna do is turn this on, and there's a delay for it to start reading. So we're just gonna leave the device there. And as you can see, it's counting down right now. So at the moment here, PPM is still calibrating. In a container farm from FarmAnywhere, we have two sensors, one in front and a little lower. And then we have another one at the back here that's a little higher. There's two reasons for that. Reason one is that there's redundancy, so that if one sensor goes down, you still have another one reading it. The second reason for it is that we're getting two different temperatures at two different heights, so we can get an average of it and make sure that the container is set up at the exact temperature that we need. So we need to calibrate them both at the same time. So how do you know which one you're calibrating? Well, on the screen, you'll see it says zone 2, and the other one at the front says zone 3 in this case. But in most farms, you'll be able to see zone 1 and zone 2. This is an R&D farm, so we do different things with sensors sometimes, and that's why the zones are a little different. So let's go back to zone 1 here, where the sensors are, or zone 2 in this case. So we're reading 24°C, 54% humidity, and 646 ppm. And then if we put that together, 613 ppm CO2. It's a little off, but not the end of the world. 22 versus 24 on the temperature side, and 56 versus 54. So humidity is within range. You want to keep in mind that these sensors, they all have an accuracy range. So you can look it up on this device here or on this device. They'll all say, for example, that the humidity is plus or minus 2%. Celsius will be 0.5 to 1.5 Celsius. Differences in resolution is also called. So you don't want to go too crazy saying, oh, it doesn't match ever. It will never match perfectly because they have those little tolerances. Another thing to be careful of is that as you are breeding, the sensor will pick up on it. So you could say, oh, there's way too much CO2 in this room, which is not the case. I'm speaking into the sensor, and therefore I'm expelling CO2 from my own breeding inside the sensor, and that can also affect the humidity, not so much for the temperature. So when you're calibrating, you want to really be careful of not only waiting a certain amount of period to make sure that the data comes in, but you also not breed into the sensor in order to change the data and make it basically detrimental to your calibration. Another thing too that you want to keep in mind when you're doing your calibration here is that being two helps, because you could tell the person at the front to update the different data that you're getting here. Because if you walk to the back, obviously this could change, and you could for sure hold it by pressing the hold, and that will hold the measurements in place. However, it could technically change a little bit here, and so being two really helps. But if you're alone, then doing the hold and just comparing one last time is not a bad thing. So we're there now, we're on hold. It's pretty good for me. Let's go to the front of the container and do the calibration for zone number 3. All right, so we've closed the light so you can see properly inside the lobby what the screen says. So basically I'm gonna go into my settings up here. I'm gonna go into calibration, and I'm gonna go into temp. And then basically I will change what it says here, 23, and I was reading 19. So I'm gonna go down to 19, confirm, and I'm gonna say this is zone 2, confirm. So 19, confirm, zone 2, save, and there you go. So when I come back later on and I do zone 3, I'm gonna select zone 3 for the next calibration. So I'm gonna go back to my settings up here, and I'm gonna go to my humidity, and then I was reading 50. So we're gonna go up to, down to 50. And this is again, zone 2, confirm, save, calibrate. And then I'll repeat one last time for my CO2 right here. And I was reading 689. And so, and then I repeat the same process again. 690, confirm. And this again is for zone 2, confirm, start. And for the CO2, it takes a little while. It basically recalibrates because the sensor is like, basically pulls air into the sensor. There's like a little suction effect that happens, and therefore it takes a little while. So once that's done, we repeat the process for the next zone, whether it's zone 3 or zone 1. And there you go, you've successfully calibrated your sensors, and you're ready to keep on growing. Right, so how do you know if your calibration was successful? Well, basically, if your 4-in-1 sensor inside the farm and your handheld device calibrator has the same data or very close to it, then you know that the calibration was successful. If you're having issues and that you're recalibrating, and they still don't match up, that means there's most likely a problem with either one of the devices, most likely the 4-in-1 sensor that's always in the farm, always exposed to the temperature. So let's have a look here. We just finished calibrating. And so I'm at 24.5, 24.9 Celsius. That's great, I have the right temperature. 81% humidity and 84. I'm within 4% range, it's okay. And then the CO2, 840, 835. I know my CO2 is fairly close as well, considering the resolutions of the devices. So I know that I'm pretty close. Maybe the humidity, I would try to redo it, because 81 and 85, it's still 4%, and for humidities, it makes a difference. But overall, that's a good way to guarantee that your calibration was successful. And that's it. That's how you calibrate your sensors inside the FarmAnywhere container using the TrolMaster system. So as you can see, it's pretty easy. It's super important to calibrate all of your sensors all the time, whether it's your PPM pens, your irrigation skid, the sensors inside the room, because if you don't trust your data, and if your data that you're getting is also wrong, then you're making bad decisions in order to try to diagnose potential issues or to optimize your grow. So it's vital that you keep in mind that your sensors and all data that you receive are always constantly doubled and triple checked. If you like this video, like it, subscribe to our channel, as we are coming out with grow guides all the time and other interesting videos as to what it's like to be a container farmer. See you on the next video.